Hey guys, a very good morning to all of you. Myself, Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So let's begin today's video. But before that, you need to know that this PDF is completely downloadable and the link of the PDF is provided in the description below. Through the Telegram channel of ours, you can download the PDF. So the very first question that we have here is, which country is providing technical assistance to India for developing villages of excellence in 12 states? So guys, here the right answer is option A, Israel. So Israel is going to provide the technical assistance for creating the villages of excellence. Okay, so you must be knowing this fact that Israel has already developed 29 center of excellences in these 12 selected states, and now the villages that are surrounding the center of excellences will be developed into villages of excellence. So basically, what do we mean by the villages of excellence? Villages of excellence would be the villages where the farmers will be equipped with the modern state of the art techniques. Okay, so they will be acquainted with the new innovative agricultural techniques and how can they grow their productivity and how can they increase their yield. So this technical assistance or this training will be provided by Israel. So that is the whole concept of village of excellence. Now let's dive deep into the news. So here you need to know that the center of excellence basically has already produced more than 25 million vegetable plants and over 387,000 quality fruit plants and training of more than 1.2 lakh farmers per year. This is all that is being done by the Center of Excellences, and it will get a boost through the Villages of Excellence initiative that Indian government as well as the Israeli government have launched in collaboration. Now, how many villages? 150 villages. Do remember the number. 150 villages are being targeted from 12 states. Okay, now the facts that can be asked directly in your examination from this news are that the tenure of this initiative is 2 years, from 2021 to 2023. The agency that will be providing the training, so it is Israeli Agency for International Development Cooperation. It is going to provide you with provide the farmers with the right kind of training. Then it is a recent development that has taken place that the new Israeli ambassador to India has been appointed, and it is Naor Gilon. So do remember this thing. Since India and Israel are celebrating 30 years of their diplomatic relations, and ambassadors do play a really significant role in boosting the bilateral diplomatic relations among the countries. Therefore, it is important for you to know the Israeli ambassador of India, that too who has been recently appointed. So it is Naor Gilon. Now, the recent development as well as the background of India-Israeli relations is also important for you to know. So, India and Israel basically have completed 30 years of diplomatic relations, but you would be surprised to know this fact that India had recognized Israel as a nation back in the year 1950, but the diplomatic relations started from the year 1992 onwards. But why is this so? This is because you must be aware of the background of Israel and how the Arabian Peninsula is not ready to accept Israel as a country. However, the situation is changing right now. Many countries in the Arabian Peninsula have already agreed to recognize Israel as a nation, as well as India has also done that. India has also worked for improving the bilateral relations with Israel. With the fact, it is evident with the fact that 43% of Israel's defense exports are basically bought by India only. So that is how India is, that is the significance that India is attaching to Israel. So this is one fact that you can use to corroborate the significance that India is giving to Israel and the bilateral relations that India and Israel are having right now. Now, the next fact here that you need to know is that India and Israel, both of them are working on the free trade agreement, which is expected to conclude by June 2022. Now, another country with which India is working on the free trade agreement is UAE. That too is also expected to conclude this year only. Next country is UK. Now, the negotiations with UK have just been launched. So, these three countries are basically, the FTAs with these three countries are basically in discussion. So, this is important, guys. Do pay attention to this thing. Now, the FTA with Israel aims to increase the bilateral trade between India and Israel to $10 billion. Right now, this trade stands at $4 billion, and this is expected to be increased to $10 billion via this free trade agreement, which is in negotiation right now. India and Israel are also planning to develop a 10-year defense cooperation plan, but this is again a plan which they are planning to conclude. Okay, now in the wake of the 30 years of diplomatic relations between India and Israel, Masada Fortress, which is located in Israel, was lit with the flags of India and Israel, as you can clearly see here. So here the question that can be created out of this entire thing is, where is Masada Fortress located? So do remember, it is located in Israel. So guys, can you tell me that what is the name of this symbol? This is a really important symbol. As you can see, it is the center point of the Israeli flag, so it has a name itself. So can you guys tell me the name of this this symbol in the comment section below? Moving ahead, with which country has India established a first of its kind venture fund to boost the growth of startups? So here guys, the right answer is UAE. So at the Expo 2020, which is being held in Dubai, so this venture fund has been launched. So let me tell you the basic purpose of launching this venture fund, which is in itself a first of its kind fund. So India and UAE, both of these countries are basically going to establish this venture fund, which will basically invest in other startups, both in India as well as in UAE. So this will basically help the startups in India and UAE to get money and thrive. Okay, so that's the basic purpose of this venture fund. Now, the funding of this fund will be from the government of UAE, India and other Gulf Cooperation Council countries. So here again, the second question that I'm throwing at you is the members of the Gulf Cooperation Council. And you must be knowing this fact that the number of the countries which are members of the GCC is not really huge. It's just 6. So do mention the names of the countries that are members of GCC. So moving further, the target of this venture fund is to at least invest in a minimum of 50 startups and create at least 10 startups into unicorn, turn 10 startups into unicorn by 2025. So guys, these are the targets. Do remember the targets, they can be asked. Next is that this fund will also help the early stage startups in India as well as UAE. This is basically a very basic point. Okay, you don't have to mug it up. Next is that Indian Angel Network Fund. It is the organization that is going to provide training, that is going to provide every kind of assistance that a startup would need in UAE. Okay, so this is going to be the mentor of the startups in UAE. Do remember this this fact. Next question is, which of the following events will not be hosted by India in 2022? So guys, here the right answer is BRICS Sherpa meeting. So recently, India has handed over the chairmanship of the BRICS to China in the 15th meeting of the Science Technology Innovation Groups steering meeting. Okay, so during that meeting, this chairmanship was handed down to China, and in the wake of that, okay, on the occasion of that meeting only, the countries, China and other member countries of the BRICS, have announced the calendar for the upcoming year, that is 2022, along with the theme of the BRICS 2022 summit. So this is going to be really interesting, at the same time very important from the exam point of view. So do listen to me carefully. Okay, so 15th meeting of the BRICS Science Technology Innovation Steering Committee was held, and during that only this shift of the chairmanship was held. Now the theme of the BRICS 2022, foster high quality BRICS partnership, usher in a new era of global development, as your SEBI examination is just at the doorstep. Okay, this is really important. Next is that the first Sherpa meeting of BRICS was held by China recently. And during the meeting, the 25 events that they are going to host in the coming year, in the 2022 year, basically the present year. So that was released. Now, out of these 25 events, 5 events will be hosted by India. And this is something that is very important for the aspirants of competitive examination. So first is the BRICS Startup Forum meeting. Second is the working group meetings on energy, biotechnology and medicine, ICT and high performance computing. So guys, pay attention to this fact that these are the three different meetings that have been clubbed into one statement, but do not consider it as just one meeting, okay? So working group meeting on energy, working group on biotechnology meeting and working group on ICT and high performance computing meeting. Okay, so these are the three meetings that will be organized. Next is the launch event of BRICS Innovation Launchpad will also be hosted by India. Launch event will also be hosted by India and this will be the knowledge hub. This launch pad will be known as the knowledge hub. Now another meeting is STIEP, which stands for Science, Technology, Innovation and Entrepreneurship Partnership Working Group meeting. This is also will be hosted by India. Now the Department of Promotion for Industry and Internal Trade is going to be the main executing body for the BRICS Startup Forum as well as the Innovation Knowledge Hub. So this Knowledge Hub is also being led by the Indian organization named DPIIT. Okay, so do pay attention to this fact. Now the meetings that are planned ahead of the meetings that I have just stated, because India is planning to host majority of these meetings by June itself. So by June all these meetings will be concluded, but that is just the plan that India has announced. We do not have the exact dates on which these meetings will be held. Obviously, when these meetings will be held and conclusions or declarations will come out, you will get to know through Spotlight and through the Daily Current Affairs video as well. So moving ahead, so here we have the meetings that are planned for the September 2022. So BRICS Young Scientist Conclave will be held, and the themes of the conclave would circumscribe around the carbon peak neutralization, biomedicine, artificial intelligence, material science, modern agriculture. So these would be these are basically the broader themes that have been announced. Okay, so the entire BRICS Young Scientist Conclave would be around these themes only, would be centered on these themes. Next is 10th BRICS Science and Technology Ministerial Meeting. Now an exhibition which will showcase the successful projects that have been undertaken under the BRICS Framework Program will also be organized at this meeting only. Next is BRICS Senior Official Meeting, BRICS S&T Innovation Meeting, Steering Committees Meeting. So all of these meetings will be held in September 2022. The part which is of utmost importance from the exam point of view is this, okay? So do prepare this part thoroughly and the theme of BRICS 2022. Next is, where is the headquarters of Global Climate Fund located? Here the right answer is Incheon, which is a place in South Korea. Here the Global Fund Climate Fund's headquarters is located. Now guys, basically, chalo, first we discuss the Global Climate Fund and then I will tell you the news associated with this fund. So this fund was created out of the Copenhagen Accord of 2009. Okay, so in 2009, a meeting was held in Copenhagen where it was decided that a Global Climate Fund would be established. Consequent of this accord, the Global Climate Fund was established in 2010 under the United Nations Framework for Climate, Framework Convention on Climate Change. So under this UNFCCC, this Global Climate Fund was established. Now what is the purpose of this fund? Since it's a fund, therefore the main purpose is to finance. Now what would be financed through this Global Climate Fund? So basically the Global Climate Fund is set up in order to give financing to the developing countries so that they can shift from the they can basically reduce their greenhouse gas emissions by shifting from the fossil fuel to the renewable energy sources. That's the basic agenda. Okay, now the funding of this fund is done by the developed countries. That's the whole idea. From developed countries, the fund generates its finances and then it mobilizes that finance to the developing world. Now what is the news? The news says that according to a report which was released by the Ludwig Maximilian University of Munich, the developing countries are not getting their share of funds from the Global Climate Fund. Okay, that's the news. Now, why are they not getting the money from this fund? The major cause of it, or we can say the most prominent cause of this, as per this report, is, as you would be surprised to know, the reason is that they are basically facing the complicated processes to get the money. So here again, the red tapism and the elongated processes which are there to get the funds sanctioned for their projects is basically hindering the countries from getting their fair share of funds and then transition from the fossil fuels to the renewable sources and reduce their greenhouse gas emissions. So this is, guys, one of the most prominent reasons that have been cited, but this is not the sole reason. Okay, do remember this thing. But apart from this fact, you also need to pay attention to this thing, that this report is altogether not at all an important report from your exam point of view. Okay, but still it was in the news, and because of this, the Global Climate Fund came into the limelight. Okay, so do remember the facts that I have told you. Now, what is the obligation of the Global Climate Fund? Oh, sorry, the developed countries to this Global Climate Fund. So the obligation is $100 billion. Now, guys, do remember this thing, that this entire initiative of the Global Climate Fund is also helpful in fulfilling the targets of Paris Agreement. Okay, and do not just get confused that in the Global Climate Fund also there is $100 billion obligation on the developed countries as well as in the Paris Agreement also. No, it's not the cumulative obligation of $200 billion. No, it's just $100 billion obligation that is there on the developed countries, and it is just basically a medium of channelizing that fund to the developing world. Okay, so it is not a commitment or not a treaty, as you can say. It is just the medium to mobilize this thing, and this $100 billion was the commitment made under the Paris Agreement. I hope that now I am clear to you all. Next question is, who has been appointed as the government's chief economic advisor? So here, guys, the right answer is option D, V. Anant Nageswaran is the person who has been appointed as a chief economic advisor. Now, guys, you can also pay attention to this fact that prior to being appointed as the chief economic advisor of India, he worked as the executive with Credit Suisse Group as well as Julius Baer Group. Okay, so this is just superfluous information that has been given here. Next is, which tennis player has made a world record by winning 21 Grand Slam tournaments? Here the right answer is Rafael Nadal. So recently, after the conclusion of, or we can say after winning the Australia Open Cup, he has become the first male tennis player to win 21 Grand Slam tournaments. Okay, so that's the history that he has created for himself. So do remember this thing, he belongs to Spain. This is another fact. Now, in the women's single, Ashley Barty has won, who is from Australia. So guys, here I would like to conclude the session for today. I hope that you have liked the video, and if you have really liked it, then do subscribe, hit the bell notification, and also you can share this video among your friends. Thank you so much, guys, for watching the video.